And we are into it now. The snow, we've been watching it all morning long lift to the north. When I came in early this morning, that wasn't anywhere near us. And we had really a pretty nice situation out there in the middle of the night. But now look at Nevada, a very, very dark, dark blue there. And that is heavy snow. And then even between Ottawa and Emporia, where Jana Corey is reporting, where it's just light snow on the radar with that wind. It makes it a major force to reckon with. So we are in it now. It is starting. It's going to be with us for at least the next 12 hours of pretty significant snow, especially the middle chunk of that 12 hours, and then we'll see it start to taper off. 100% chance of snow in your backyard today. 30% chance of some lingering snow showers tomorrow morning, but mostly tomorrow will be kind of a blowing snow, cold situation for you. So, and then we dry out and are quiet for about 3-4 days. 13 degrees in Kansas City. And this storm, as we've talked about, stretches over, you know, almost two-thirds of the nation, really. 55 in Memphis, they'll not only have some winter weather to deal with, but some thunderstorm activity. Severe weather potential for New Orleans and Atlanta. So this is quite an energetic storm here that's going to bring spring-like severe storms to the south. Winter weather for almost everybody else, Chicago in particular, a couple feet of snow possible there. And then this all will converge in the northeast again. So they're watching it right now, but they know it's headed their direction again, and they'll get it toward the end of the week. Temperatures 2 below 0 in Grand Island. Look at Casper, Wyoming now, 20 below zero. That's not the wind chill. That's the actual temperature. And that very cold air will be here starting today, but especially tomorrow and Thursday morning, well below zero. Make sure the pets, even if they're outdoor dogs, make sure they have an indoor place to go to stay warm and water and food and all that kind of good stuff. Because if it's way, way too cold for you to be out there and dangerously cold, it's dangerously cold for your pets as well. All right, here's a look at clouds and radar and really the nucleus of energy. You can tell where it is. We're on the northwestern fringe of it. But you can see down along the I-44 corridor, Springfield, in the midst of what they are calling their major blizzard event. And that's what they have going on now. Little Rock has showers and thunderstorms. And then that freezing precipitation in between that's going to coat things. They're going to have some power outages down here in the Ozarks and the Boot Heel because of that coated electrical lines and tree branches and so on. And we may have enough snow, although our snow will be fairly light. It'll be kind of that light, fluffy kind because it's that cold out now. But we will still have to watch for some branches and that kind of thing that could snap off. Here's FutureScan. You know, it's just a big blue blob all day. This is noon. This is 5, and it's still snowing. And then we get to the evening. Maybe by 10 o'clock, Brian Busby may be able to bring you a little good news about it all tapering off. But then we're going to have to start talking about the wind blowing in here. So snow spreading out, winds picking up. It kind of looks just like that from Jana's live shot. Heavy snow at lunchtime, gusty winds out of the northwest, 20 to 30. And then this afternoon, 13 degrees, dangerous situation, bitter cold. Northwest winds will be blowing it around. Visibility will be an issue. So if you don't have to be out, don't be out just for your own sake. Be patient. Wait a day to do whatever you were going to do because by tomorrow afternoon it'll be brutally cold, but you'd have a better chance of getting done what you want to get done. Snow tapers tonight, but the wind's still howling. Tomorrow, 5 degrees with some sunshine. Cold comfort, probably. 12 below on Thursday morning. So more schools will be closed tomorrow because of the blowing snow. Schools will be closed again some on Thursday because of the dangerous cold. We get a little respite by Friday, Saturday. Sunday, 35. That snow chance is pretty minimal. And then next Monday, 37, which will make us feel like we're in San Diego.